Welcome to Git Forum. In this video, I'm going to talk regarding job life in government sector organizations. Let it be PSUs or let it be completely pure government sector organizations, what kind of life people used to lead. So majority of the people who are preparing for Git exam, so they have dream or they have interest to work in the government sector organizations. So why this field is, why people are so much passionate about this field and what things actually attract the people? Okay, let's see. So various factors are written. So salary, job security, social value, various facilities and other priorities. So what are these? Let's talk one by one. Coming to the salary. So what kind of life you'll be living? So it all depends on how much salary you earn in a month. Okay. So this is a decent money they are paying it. Okay, so let me tell you a rough idea. Actually, so if you see the notifications of all the PSUs, so they used to tell basic, DA, these, that. So once you come into these sectors, so you'll be understanding, you know, there is proper calculations, but no need to get involved into that much of calculations. But roughly I'm telling you, the gross salary, I mean the CTC, okay, in any of the PSU sectors, it varies in the range of 55k to 80k, the gross. And in hand salary, if you ask me, it varies from 48k, it goes up to 70k. This is the starting salary I'm telling you. Okay, and there are some exceptions. Like some of the PSUs, they're giving some incentive based on the, you know, a profit what they are getting in a particular year, but roughly I'm speaking, so this is the range. So if you join ONGC, if you join Airport Authority, if you join BSNL, okay, in all these organizations, so the range I'm telling you, it is 48k to 70k per month in hand salary will be getting, and these are the deductions, and those deductions, that's also your money only, but there are some EPF and some pension schemes, retirement benefits. So they get this money. So that money which they are deducting, at least, you know, 10 to 12 thousands, long run they are going to get the benefit of it. But in general, this is the salary. And this is a decent money, right? So even I remember when I was doing my BTEC, so before 15, 17 years, that time software company which were coming to my colleges, they're offering the package of 2.5 to 3 lakhs. And even today I see, I ask my students who are getting placed in all these IT companies, again the package is same. That means in last 15 to 20 years, the salary range, the starting salary range of software employees, so that is like kind of stagnant, it is not increasing. Okay, and even some cases very bad, even people who are staying in Bangalore, Hyderabad, so they are getting a salary of 15,000 to 20,000. So 15,000, 20,000 in this kind of metro cities, it is not even hand-to-mouth situations. You have to again take help of your family members, right? So in the age of, if you are getting your BTEC degree in the age of 21, 22, okay, and if you are getting the PSUs, you know, let's take a 3 year of gap, okay, in a, you know, window of 3 years. So by the age of 25, if you are getting a salary of around 50,000, it's quite good. And that to be, you might be knowing like in this COVID periods, how many people have lost their jobs and all. Okay, so the next thing is the job security. Okay, so job security, that's what I was telling you, in this corona period, so many people, so many organizations, it is being closed, lots of hiring happened, and the situation of job is very bad in India as of now. And the vacancies, even in the government sectors and even in the private sectors, are drastically hampered. So we are also hearing some positive news, the IT companies are coming up with huge vacancies. But in general, the job opportunities after the corona, it's taken a bad shape. But people who are working in this government sectors, not a single employee got fired. Their salary used to come on time. So on that last working day of the month itself, they're getting the money. Job security. So unless until you are not going into too extreme, so, you know, till the age of 60, 62, so, you know, you are kind of, your job is secure. Now, you may have arguments. So, these days, we are hearing lots of news about privatizations, these, that. So, what will happen? See, what I feel is, people have tendency to talk something, right? So, if somebody asking or somebody saying, PSU will be privatized, then my question is, if PSU will be privatized, what to do then? What will you do? So you don't want to work in softwares, you don't have a family business, you are like a normal family, you know, like from a normal middle class family, like where majority of us are. So in that case, what will you do then? So So do remember, even if privatization is happening, okay, so privatization doesn't mean like, you know, they are simply firing you. That doesn't happen that way. So there will be structures. Again, new employer will again hire the old. There are lot many things. But I'll suggest even if privatization happens and all, your job is not going. So there might be some compromise on the benefits and might be salary structures, but job is not going even if privatization happens. And the biggest hurdle for government is, if you are, you know, if you are privatizing a particular organizations, what will be doing, will be doing for the employees? So they should be transferred into some other organizations, other government organizations, or even if we are terminating them, a lump sum amount they'll be giving you. So no way you are going to lose it. So it's a very common talk among the students, like this ye ho raha hai privatization isme karke kya fayda ye wo cheeze ye sab mein fasne se kya hoga, those people who are talking. So they'll be keep on talking, at the end they'll not do anything and they will only blaming you. So they need a topic and they just want to discuss it. So whenever you see hear such kind of negative news, just ignore it. Because what other options you have? And that is happening if for everyone, then where you'll be going then, right? So in general, job security in the government sectors or the PSU sector is quite good once you are joining. So 33 years or till the age of 60, so you'll have your job is secured. And even I'm telling you, I have seen some cases. Unfortunately, if you get some health issues, okay. So if you have, in private sectors, so if you have good relations, you are a good employee of the organizations, so they will be bearing you hardly for, might be 1 month or 2 months, or even in your family to your parents, some health issue is there, you need to go there to, support in those kind of critical situation or some other situation in the family. So leaves and all in the private sectors are very much limited, right? If you talk regarding leaves, your boss used to, like, the face used to change, and there are a lot of other unwanted situations. But in the PSU sectors, it is having a, higher benefit, like there are so many leaves and all. So you can plan a lot of many things. So that way also you can give proper attention to your family. See, at the end, why you are doing all these things? So, just earning money is not the goal of life, isn't it? So you need in a happy life. And when I say happy, so there are different ways to define this happy. And I believe for everyone, family comes in that happy zone, right? So giving proper attention to the family, it also matters. And in some critical situations, like when health issues and all, if you are not able to support your parents and your loved one, then what is the purpose of earning money? So that way, getting leaves and other things in the private sectors takes a backseat compared to the government organizations. There are so many CL, EL, okay, different kind of leaves where you can take and you can give proper attention to family members. Social value. Social value, okay, I believe you know this, and it's a common thing that's been happening. When people, somebody, they used to describe someone, and if somebody is working in government sectors, they say, he, wo government sector mein kahin pe kaam karta hai. It means, what I wanted to say is, they have a very positive impression on you. Okay. So it makes sense, social values. And during I think in particularly in India, many of you might have heard this and you have seen this, when marriage and all happens, so you know what is the importance of the government jobs. Like a girl's family, they always want, the boys should be working in the government sector so that the daughter will be secured. So I don't believe all these things, but this is what is being happening in India. Okay, so directly or indirectly, it makes sense. It is having social values. Various facilities. So what are the various facilities? Like, you get quarter to stay, you get health benefits. So depending on company to companies, up to what, there are certain limits. So if you have health issues and all, so you will get that money. Okay, like the bills what you are getting in the private hospitals for a simple things, they are putting a bill of 1 lakh, 2 lakh, 3 lakhs. So those kind of headache and all, so it will somewhat to relax you. If you are working in these sectors, one is, as we say, quarter facilities, you get accommodation to stay on campus majorly, and health facilities. Apart from these, there are some leave allowances and some other facilities. Okay, and other priority. Other priority means, for example, let's say if you are looking for a loans and all, right? So if you go to any banks and all, so they will be telling you, like, if you are working in the PSUs or government sectors, so the bond and all the security and all what people used to give, so there will be certain relaxations if you are working in these segments. So if I actually keep on writing all of these, right? So each and every point, so this board will be full. But roughly, I'm telling you. So these are the benefit, and that's why everyone is quite interested for. So majorly, if I want to summarize this, the main thing is the job security and salary. So these are two things. Okay, that's what somebody need to live a very good, comfortable life in private segments. You don't know like how it is a relative things. Even if you are a good employee, how your company is doing in the markets. That's one thing. Second thing, due to some issues, you have to take leaves, so you may get fired. And there are so many situations, unwanted situations. You don't know where your job, when your job will go if you are in the private sectors. In government sector is not there. And so many other facilities, as I said. I hope you have liked this video. And if you need some particular PSU informations, what happens in ISRO, what happens in Indian Railways, what happens means what is the job life, what happens in airport, what happens in BSNL, what happens in maybe NALCO, maybe NTPC, maybe BHEL, all the organizations. So if you are interested, you know, please do write in the comment box. I have students who are working in these organizations. I'll try to arrange a conversations. Okay, these things, we can plan something good for you. So that's what for in this video. Thanks for watching. Keep liking and subscribing these videos if you have not subscribed. Thank you.